What are some good, strong, basic ways to use social media to grow your business?
First, what I like to tell small businesses is to think, every time we use the phrase social media, don't get weirded out by that. Think of that as partly just like the phone. If you were saying, how do you do business via the phone? Then it's easy. You say, well, I mean, we discuss our product a little bit more when people ask us questions, etc. It's the same thing, except that the context of social media is a little different. Everyone's not on there just eager to hear about your product just yet. They're having their own conversation. So you need to work on understanding how to get involved in those conversations, how to pick who might be a prospect versus when you're jumping over a line somewhere and interrupting a conversation. And the way to do that at first is just start to see how other people are using the tools. See how, if you're on Twitter or Facebook or Google Plus, how are people representing themselves as a business on there? And you'll see the ones that are successful, and you'll see things that make you feel a little uncomfortable. And there's a little bit of monkey see, monkey do that can help you start. I would say that one of the things small businesses tend to do a little wrong at first is they start by just promoting. If you were at a cocktail party, you wouldn't come up and shake someone's hand and say, "You should see what I sell. I'm amazing." You would ask about the other person. The same holds true. You really need to build a relationship before you start for the sale.
What are some sample examples of what they can tweet out or share that's not promotional, if they're kind of at a loss for that?
Well, let's say I'm Polar Fitness and I sell heart rate monitors. My friend Chris Zoller works for Polar, and what he'll tweet about is five things a budding triathlete should learn before going from either cycling or running or whatever. And so it's information that's useful to that kind of person, and then you build a rapport by curating other people's content. And then you've earned the ability to sell, because then the person's like, wow, I can't believe the guy from Polar. He's always giving me good information. As a person just learning how to go from being a runner into a triathlete, then this will really help me. And then if he says, and by the way, triathletes tend to use this out of our line of products, this is the one they use versus what a runner uses, you've earned that sale. And I think that this is the way the businesses can participate. And it works for pretty much every business. There's your buyer is on the social web. There's always that question, my customers aren't online. Social media is the number one visited set of sites in the entire world right now. It's the top five types of sites people visit are social and then search engines. And everything that you're doing in social media contributes to search, and search is how people find you. 69% of people come to your website via a search, and social media gives it even more potential context to find it.
So people can find you and your business easier the more active you are on social networks.
Absolutely, Terry. Mm-hmm. And you know, the newest social network, Google Plus, even more so. They just announced yesterday that regular search in Google is now going to be influenced by the people that you are connected to in your social network in Google Plus. Mm-hmm. So if you have a Gmail account, then there's already some kind of activity going on like this, but this is Google saying, we're taking into account what your friends also search for, because it's likely that you're all going to be looking for similar things. Mm-hmm. So that'll impact search in a very big way for businesses.